Everybody should have a Frankenstein jacket. That's what this is. So it has been brought back to life in so many different ways. Clearly, we use this thing, and it shows it. So we're looking today at lever systems, so a little bit of physics. When somebody's pushing on you, so she's got this, and she happens to have a Frankenstein jacket or any other kind of jacket on, all you're going to do is you're going to displace this energy that's going out here, and you're going to put it out here. So the way that you find out the proper break point is you send energy back, and then you just kind of vary it off at the angle slightly, and you'll just keep going out until you feel that break in their base. So in this case, I'm going like this. That already alleviates some of the pressure that she's got in there, but she gives me a little more pressure. There we go. Then I turn it outward. So now her pressure on here is butting up against this, which is now driving outward. I've found this here break point. So now the more she pushes, she's pushing hard, the more I push out in that direction. She's really going, as you can see, for me, it's like I can be up on tippy toes and whatever else, and it's not affecting my base. It's because I'm really working, driving her out that way, not back into her, because then that's muscle for muscle, mass for mass. I don't need to do that. I'm displacing that angle of pressure. So whatever she's got in here, I'm diverting the mass of it, or I'm diverting the angle of it, or the vector of it outward. It's losing some of its push, so to speak. So it doesn't seem like it would actually work, but it truly does. It's pretty easy. So same pressure, so she's pushing, so she can actually move me. She's got some oomph. So when I go like this and I turn it outward, there we go. So now she's doing that same amount of pushing, and I just keep going out that way. And it's forward. I'm not actually taking it and continually going this way with it. I'm not trying to rotate her outward. The effect is that the muscles that activate that will be moving out in this direction, because they have to still counter the force that's coming in this path. But my goal is to push outward in a direction that goes here. So it's a continual forcing outward against what she's doing, but forward. If I just went outward like this, and she kept driving forward, so she would still push me over. So I can't do that. I can't just, you know, go outward and think this is going to work. I go, again, to test this, you push, and then you vary it off to the side a little bit until you get to a point where it's like an equilibrium, where she's working really hard, put full fist, do whatever else you can. And she's leaning into it, she's got some pressure on it. And then I'll do that in the second wearing this, so that she gets the feel for it. So pressure forward and then slightly outward until you find that break point in pressure, my exertion versus her pressure forward, where that equilibrium is, to where I no longer have to keep pushing too hard this way or pushing outward slightly. So it's always driving that direction. So again, she's leaning into it. She's putting everything she's got into it. I just keep going out in that direction. So I can push her. So now I will do that same amount. So she's going to take her angle as I push. So, yep, you're going to vary it outward a little bit more. Forward, forwards, and then outwards. So, so it's a little difficult for me to do that. So I outweigh her by a bit, and I do have a bit more strength. Try the other side. Same setup, because this side's stronger.
I'll lose it at some point.
But. There you go. Yeah. So you can see even there, what this does is it buys a person time. It also allows you to retain your balance and your positioning. You know, all fights aren't just some giant massive attacker. Sometimes it might be your preacher. It might be somebody at a party who had too much to drink, who's a friend that you don't want to actually kill or maim or paralyze in some way or risk going to prison over. So not all circumstances require you to actually deal with the person as a life threat. So some of these situations are like this, okay? They're just doing that. If they're wearing clothing, it's easier to do. I can even just taking that off, that the same mechanics of my driving forward and turning outward make this come off a lot easier. And so that means I can then utilize moving the person the rest of the way quite easily. She's coming in, I just take that and move it out. It's that requires very little work on my end. I don't have to do much and they'll fall into it. So if I'm grabbing it like this, go slow for a second. If I grab this and move it off before she makes contact or even slightly after, and they're really putting energy into it, they'll fall forward into it. Which means at that point, that's where your other hand goes to the head. So I will take this, move it, and control it. So I'll keep it. I will keep my control on the piece of material. And varying materials, of course, has varying stretch and so forth. So you get a different, you've got to test it out with a lot of different things. And we'll do it without clothing, so you get an idea here, without the Frankenstein. Not that type of without clothing. So we're going through here, pulling outward just to clear this. I don't want to bring it so far out that I extend myself beyond the need for it. And that would mean I put in too much muscle, too much resources for the action. Just enough to get this off here, which brings them forward if they're going into it. And then I go along the jawline. Now, that could be a strike, a palm strike, which you know we prefer. Or that could be just control and pushing. So I may start moving and rotating in this direction. If you work Aikido, you know what type of movement this is. But I maintain this control and this pulling at the same time as pushing and then working the circle movement. So I could put her into another opponent, or I could put her into furniture or whatever else it happens to be, or the pew if it happens to be the pastor. So so this is not unheard of. There are many things in life that will surprise you what has happened to people. And we'll go into how can you do this without that Frankenstein jacket. Hooking can occur on the outside or the inside. We prefer inside because the mentality of JKD or their mentality of Wing Chun, if you're thinking about that, is to get to the inside because I want to access centerline as early as possible. So with this same mentality, I can just go into here, clear this a little bit, and do the same mechanics. But in Wing Chun, it's going to be more like this. It's going to be like that movement. So you've got your tonsil coming in with your palm strike. A lot of times people, of course, go with the vertical fist. Palm strike, I tell you, on a hit, it will shock somebody tremendously. There's a lot of surface area contact. You don't slip if they bob and weave well or they move. You still get a lot more surface area that can contact. So it's like another reason to use the palm strike. But the method of coming out here, even if I just wanted to do it for testing lever against her resistance, I'm going to use my finger to push out. So she's just going to push on me. I'm going to just push out in that direction and maybe slightly off to the side. Now she's pushing and pushing and pushing and trying to put as much energy as she can into it. And again, I'll just go outward slightly with it, depending on how much more I need to put into her. I don't go adding more in a straight line, I add more in the outward line. That helps counter whatever she's doing with that pressure here. So that does, again, a couple of different things. I'm using less energy for the effect. I'm not moving my base, I'm not changing range. She's not getting what she wants as far as intimidation or making me change range, things like that. And I'm keeping this out here. This, again, if you're going into Wing Chun, we're looking like that. If this breaks off here like that, that's a Wing Chun trapping mentality. Tonsil to here, check it, and go into there. She's got rear hand response up that helps her protect against that. The other is the outside hook. So if I wanted to go like this and she's putting that pressure in, I can just take my fingers and pull slightly to the outside. What I'm doing is creating a little bend in the arm. So she's pushing again. I'm just gonna keep pushing outward. This one I have to push outward because of how the hooking motion of your muscles that activate the fingers like that can go like that. There's not a lot I can do with pushing on that. I'm at a disadvantage strength-wise to do that. So here though, I just collapse it outward. So she's putting a lot of energy into it and I'm just putting more energy out that way. And it doesn't move me, and that's the key. The other is you're creating a triangle. I did this on one of the earlier videos. So when a person has even their arm down or not, if I take this and create, basically I'm creating a triangle here, and I'm pushing against that base of the triangle, and she's pushing into me, I just keep driving forward. So slightly up and forward. And that alleviates a lot of the problems. So she's gonna try and keep it on centered. There we go. And again, I can move my feet however I want. So that's always in there. So again, on this side, same thing. She's pressuring to go outward here. That'll come off. We go right into the palm strike. Yeah, rear hand response is always up. So again, just what's needed, just what's needed. I don't go way out here. That's excessive, takes too much time. Distance is time. So out here, check it, go in. Out here, strike. Out here, palm strike. So this pressure here, all she does, and the way you visualize that is just take that index finger and point. That index finger is gonna be your direction for sending your energy, which is pressure and direction, pressure along a direction. So you're just gonna hold it, and I'm gonna just try pushing on you. So just keep the tension on here right now. So the more you push forward with your finger, there you go. Yep. There you go. But this is against my strength and my mass, and yet she can do that. So now if I'm doing this to push her out and to actually make her go into another zip code range, she's gonna goes in like that. There you go. It's just turn it out. Oh, there we go. That's the big difference. So that's the motion, is just right there. Finger comes out, and that's efficiency. So bam, oh yeah, before I get there even, there we go, or afterwards. And then that goes up to the jawline. So in here, or she can do that with that same hand. So that's also something which is here and inside. So tonsil up, which comes in, boom, just right to there. That way the hand that's already in play is closest to target, is the one that strikes. So bam, bam, right there. If she wants to switch it out, she wants to check, because maybe I've got this one in the way, she can do that. Or she can just go ahead and strike with that one. Bam, okay. Palm strike with it, right there. That's all available. So, and again, so if I'm pushing and she just even does this one and just keeps that pressure, the more she keeps that little pressure, the more I can drive into this, and I'm putting that much weight into her and it's not causing her to move any substantial amount. So you're using that with the Wing Chun base and mechanics, that it's all part of JKD. So if you think about it that way, it's just that there you can become proficient in one area, you can be proficient in another, but JKD is proficient in all areas. And we have to be dynamic. We have to be able to adapt, okay, very quickly without thinking. And Core JKD is an extension going deeper into things for street survival period. When we're working along all of these pathways, it doesn't always require the lethal aspects of what we do. And that's what you're always looking for, because lethality means legal system, unless you're in some other country where they have very little value for life. My military people trained completely differently. They don't have that same type of thing to worry about in war. But being here in the United States and wherever you are in the world, you have legal system that you have to deal with, and you don't want to always have to sit in front of a jury or with a judge and figure out where you went wrong as far as, could I just have gone like this in any situation and said, hey, the parking spot is yours. It's perfectly okay. I don't mind. I don't mind walking the extra, 30 feet. I could use the exercise. Thank you for giving me that opportunity today. I was going to be lazy and just take a nice close parking spot to the store. That sort of thing. So turn it around, whatever it happens to be, into a positive for you and mean it, because the more nice you put out there, the less anger has to bounce off of. You put anger against anger, man, that's what you get. And there is always that ego play. But anger is absorbed by nice. So you keep a sensibility about you. You keep, awareness. You don't turn your back. You keep an eye towards threats, that sort of thing. Being nice does not mean you're stupid. Does not mean you're being unaware. Okay? So be safe out there. Thank you guys and girls for the comments. There's quite a few, and I'm working on them. And some are really entertaining. And you guys, some of you have some really interesting life stories. And thank you for telling me. They are head scratchers at times. And they are also things that I'm really glad what we are doing here is helping you. A lot of people have come under situations that they've actually used some of the materials here on our channel to help them in defense situations, and I'm glad that worked for you. That's what I'm here for. So again, questions, comments, put it in there and share, and thumbs up if you haven't, and certainly subscribe if you haven't as well. Grow our channel. Thank you.